ठीक है। सो व्हेन वी अप्लाई द पैरामेट्रिक टेस्ट वी एस्टिमेट द नॉर्मेलिटी ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर वेरिएबल्स। नॉर्मेलिटी मींस आवर डेटा शुड बी लाइक, इज इट क्लियर? हेलो,
कोई बात नहीं, इट्स ओके।
एक्चुअली okay, some voice is coming from your side. Okay, no problem. So basically data should be normally distributed, means ki data shape should be bell shaped data. Okay, if our data like this, then we can say our data is normally distributed, because our data may be skewed, either a positive skewed, this is positive skewness, and this is negative skewness. Is it clear? So, but this is desirable, and we do not want this type of skewness in data. And second is homogeneous. Homogeneity means data should be homogeneous. There are two group, one group and second group. Okay, so if we give the there are two things, one x1 and second x2, it means the distribution of the data, the range should be, data should be constant across the group. Now here, so I am taking an example of this is the sales and this one advertising expenses. If our advertising expenses 1 lakh rupees, and then sales maybe this is the 10 lakh, it is the mean value. Someday sales may be 13 lakh, someday 14 lakh, someday 10 lakh, 8 lakh, 7. But mean value is 10. And this is our range. So range should be, if range is 13 to 8, means 5. Then if we incurred 2 lakh rupees on advertising, then the mean sale would be 20 lakhs, someday 23 lakhs, other day 22, then 18, 17. It means this is the range. It means if range of the data is like this, then we can say data is homogeneous. Means distribution of the observation should be constant across the group. If the group distribution of the group across the group same, range same, then we can say our data homogeneous. If range is like this, one range is this and second range this, then this is the heterogeneous type of data. So normal and as well as homogeneous, the both the assumptions we perform through the SPSS, we find the normality of the data and as well as homogeneity of the data. And third, these variables, these assumptions like data should be continuous, we should prepare our questions and ordinal or continuous data. And independent score means the score of one respondent will be different from the another response. So score should be independent. So generally, before applying any statistical tool and technique or parametric test, we estimate the normality of the data and well as homogeneity of the data. Okay, now question is how to find the normality of the data. Now question ki how to, what are the method to find the normality of the data and how to find or estimate the normality homogeneity of the data. So we will focus on the two. One is normality of the data and second is homogeneity of the data. Now the assumptions of parametric test means normality of the data. The assumption first is through graphical display, means through graph we can estimate the normality of our data. Second way to estimate the normality through value of skewness and kurtosis. And third is KS and Shapiro test. So there are three ways to find the normality of our data, either graphical display, distribution and normality test. So generally we use normality of the data through KS test. So we find or estimate normality through the KS test. Is it clear? So we report normality of the data in our research paper or thesis KS test. Okay, and homogeneity of the, how to find the homogeneity? So we find the homogeneity through the Levin test. Okay, so these are the method. Now question is, what is graphical method? What is skewness, kurtosis, and Levin test homogeneity? So I'll explain one by one. So first, assessing the normality. So normality, we can assess normality. One is, there are two ways to through graph we can estimate the normality. One is histogram. Histogram means histogram. It is like the picture of histogram of this. Is it clear? So this is our x-axis and this one is y-axis. How to create x-axis? If we are using a 7-point scale, means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is it clear? So my question is, I like this product. Okay, and I have given 7 choices, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It means poor to excellent. If you like the product, then you can take 6. If you like the product, you can take 7. If you do not like the product, then you can take either 2, 3, 1. Is it clear? So how to prepare the histogram? This is the number, means frequency. In a y-axis, we can see the frequency 5, 10, 20, 25, and so on. The question one means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Number of people means if 5 people are taking only this one option, 2 people are taking 7, 3 people this, 4 people, 4 means 20 respondents take the 4, and so on. So we create our graph like this. Is it clear? So this is our normally distributed data. But sometimes what happens when we create our question in the Likert scale, means strongly disagree to strongly agree in a 5-point scale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So generally what happens, maximum people tick either 4, 5, 4, 5 or 1, 2, 1, 2. So what happens if maximum people are taking 1, 2, 1, 2? It means frequency of 1, 2, 5 means maximum number of people are taking this. So our data may be skewed. So this type of skewness is known as the positive skewness. And if the maximum people are taking 4 or 5, this type of skewness known as negative skewness. Okay, positive left hand side and negative right hand side. So do not confuse that the concentration of the data in left hand side, it is negative, it is positive, and in right hand side we can see negative skewness. Okay, so but this is desirable for applying any parametric test. Second is PP or QQ plot. Basically the observations when on the principal diagonal maximum observations are like this, then we can say our data is normally distributed. If deviation of the particular observations are above and below, if this it is taking the shape of above and below this type, then our data is not normally distributed. So there are the two ways to find the normality of the data through graph. One is histogram and second is and that is a PP or QQ plot. Okay, now we understand the skewness concept of skewness and kurtosis. So kurtosis and the value of the kurtosis and kurtosis and skewness should be minus 1 to plus 1. It should be between the minus 1 and plus 1. So second method, that is, so this is the histogram, example of histogram. Now we can see here the normality of the data. Through our data should be normally distributed, means shape of the distribution should bell shape, venti ki shape mein data should be normally distributed, bell shape data. If it is taking skewed, then this type of skewness, positive skewness, again it is positive skewness. The both the data not desirable for our study, only this particular data desirable for our study. Is it clear? Now the PP plot, I told you, if the maximum observation on the principal diagonal, then we can say our data normally distributed. If data deviate from the principal diagonal, then we say this data not normally distributed. So we can say the day one data, the data normally distributed, but the other two graph are showing that the, there is no there is no normality of the data. Okay, now QQ plot, again through QQ plot we can identify the normality of the data. Here we can say maximum observations in the QQ means quantile quantile plot, and PP means probability probability plot. Okay, so quantile quantile plot, again all the observations should lie on this particular principal diagonal. If the data deviate from the principal diagonal, then we can say data is not normally distributed. So here we can see this data is more or less normally distributed, but this say graph second and graph three are showing that the data is normally because data is curving. Okay, it's shape is curve, so it is not normally distributed. Now this is the first method to find the normality of the data, and second is we can find the normality of the data through the skewness and kurtosis. Now how to find the skewness and kurtosis? So here we can see the value of the skewness and kurtosis, means value of the skewness and kurtosis should be between the minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, so that means if our data is minus 0.41 or a plus 0.53 or 0.83, then we can say if values of skewness and kurtosis, if it is between the minus 1 to plus 1, then we can say our data is normally distributed. So we should understand what is kurtosis. The meaning of kurtosis is, so through what is kurtosis? Kurtosis kurtosis means the it is again showing the distribution of the data. If my data, okay, so I am creating the picture of a kurtosis. This is my data. If cases are less, then my data would come like this. So this is known as platykurtic, platykurtic data. If number of observations increase, then my data would be like this. Okay, so I'm making again this because it is not proper. So I'm I'm preparing the kurtosis. So if my data like this, distribution of data, because it depend on the sample size of the data. Okay, if sample size data, so this type of distribution kurtosis known as platykurtic. Okay, if number of observations increase, then my graph would be like this. This is mesokurtic data. And if observations, again, if observation increase, so my data like this. This is the leptokurtic data. Okay, So through formula, when we apply the formula, SPSS by default give the value of kurtosis and skewness between the values are between the minus one and plus one, then we can say our data normally distributed. Okay, but ideally the value should be zero, but it is rarely. It means we do not get zero. So either we get minus 13, minus 1.21, 2.8. It means if it is away from this range, then data not normally distributed. Okay. Now, after this, these are the two methods to find the skewness. Through skewness and kurtosis, we can find the normality of the data. Okay. Now, third method is KS test, Kolmogorov-Smirnov test. Okay. So when we apply the KS test, our p value should be greater than 0.05. It means our p value should be non-significant. Is it clear? So we should keep in mind when we estimating the normality of the data or homogeneity of the data. So p value should be greater than 0.05, means it should be greater than 5%, then our data is normal. It is opposite to the checking the significant difference between the two variables. If we want to find the significant impact of one variable on other, then p value should be less than 0.05. But for assumptions case, normality and homogeneity, both the p value should be greater than 0.05. okay. So this is to checking the value of the normality and homogeneity. So next, that is the assessing of the homogeneity. So homogeneity, I told you, the homogeneity basically disperseness of observation in the particular categories. So we find homogeneity only when we have two groups. Is it clear? Means male and female. If the distribution of the data, like so here are the distribution of the data. So data should be, if p value greater than 0.05, it means our data homogeneous. And how will we estimate the p value? So we use Levene test to estimate the homogeneity of the data. So now we have two methods. One method for checking the normality of the data, we use KS test. For homogeneity of the data, we use Levene test, and both the test p value should be greater than 0.05. if both the test values are greater than 0.05, we can say our data normal and as well as homogeneous. Once both the conditions satisfied, then we can use our parametric test. We can use parametric test for one sample, two sample, and many, means more than two sample. Is it clear? Now, Levene test, I discussed through graph how to understand the homogeneity of the graph. So I have taken this example from the book of Andy Field. If you want to understand more, so you can go through the ND field and title of ND field book, Discovering Statistics Through SPSS. So you go through this book. So I am explaining the homogeneity of variance through this example. Example is this. There are some music festival and the company name Brixton Academy, Brighton, Bristol, these are the company name, they perform the music festival. So, and logically we can see the ringing hours. If I am attending this particular program, so I can listen the voice of the ringing after means after 10 hours to 15 hours. If I'm at, if someone attending the this particular company program, the ringing hours this means 15 to 20, and this third company 16 to approximately 22. So these are the distribution of the data. What does it mean? I will try to explain this. So now you can say this is, or it is more or less, it is near to 10, okay, and it is near to 15. This is the range. Range means maximum 15 and minimum 10. And what is the range? 5. And here the 18 to 13, what is the range? 5. Here the 22 to 18, here 25 to 19 or 24 to, it means this is the range. Range should be constant across the group. If the range of the distribution of the data across the group more or less same, then we can say our data is normally distributed. Because here we can draw the normal probability curve. Normal probability curve, we can draw the normal probability curve like this. Okay, now second heterogeneous, the distribution of the data, the range of the data, this is the range, and for second this one range, but all the range are not same across the group. Some range less and some range we are giving a high. Okay, so this data is not normally distribution. So this is not our so we can say our data not normally distribution. Okay, now we can understand. I'm taking simple example to explain this homogeneity concept. Okay, I'm taking the example. So means if I'm this is my I'm taking example here, you can see this is this one. Okay, so I am, this is this. Okay, so here male and second female. Okay, so here we can see the monthly weekly expenditure by male and female. Okay, so per day, so I have taken data of 1 week. So here I can in y-axis unit rupees. Okay, so the mean is 10,000. So someday, and this is the mean 10,000 rupees, and someday a particular man expenditure, that is 5,000, someday 6,000, 8,000, 10,000, 11,000, this is the distribution. And the female weekly,
sorry to disturb, sir.
Hello,
sorry. Screen is not visible, sir.
Sorry to interrupt. I think Kilai Govindanam J has started presenting their screen. Kindly, sir, switch off.
Yeah, sir,
can you see sir screen or not?
Yes, sir.
No, sir, not yet.
Tab se nahi dekh pa rahe.
No, sir, just a visit.
Actually, somebody else started presenting.
The moment you started creating that graph.
So you are not able to see the screen, na?
No, sir. Somebody else started sharing their screen.
Now, can you see this slide?
Just to share sir entire screen sir.
Sir, sir pin icon बनाया pin को click कीजिएगा तो आपका शायद आ जाएगा.
Yes sir.
Pin उस pin का icon बनाया pin the screen करके उसको click कीजिए. Board pin का जो icon बनाया आपके screen पे.
हाँ क्या बनाया?
Board pin का icon pin.
हाँ जी
sir वहाँ pin पे click कीजिए pin पे click कीजिए.
Pin पे click कीजिएगा तो full screen हो जाएगा आपका.
अच्छा
right corner पर है.
सर अभी नहीं आ पा रहा ना स्क्रीन?
नहीं सर.
एक मिनट अभी मैं
बोर्ड पिन पे क्लिक कीजिए सर.
आप सर फिर से प्रेजेंट कर दें.
एक मिनट सर मैं इसको स्टॉप शेयरिंग कर देता हूँ ना.
फिर से शेयर
मैं दोबारा से शेयर कर लेता हूँ. Is it visible?
Yes sir, yes sir.
Yes sir, yes, sir. No visible.
Yes, yes, sir. अब आप स्क्रीन देख सकते हैं सर?
Yes, जी सर.
ओके थैंक यू देखिए मैं एक चीज बताने वाला हूँ कि अगर कोई भी चीज आपको ना हो समझ ना आए तो तुरंत मुझे रोक दीजिएगा है ना जिससे मैं जो है इसको करेक्ट कर सकूं.
ओके सर.
ओके ओके नाउ सो नाउ आई थिंक यू कैन सी द स्क्रीन. सो आई डिस्कस द होमोजेनिटी ऑफ द वेरिएंस. सो वी अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ होमोजेनिटी एंड एज वेल एज नॉर्मलिटी ऑफ द डेटा. ओके नाउ आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग द एक okay now is it visible na?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay
yes,
sir. Thank you. So first of all before applying any parametric test we check the normality and homogeneity of the data. In case our data not normal not homogeneous then we correct our data. So there are three ways to correct our data. One is log transformation. Through log transformation we correct our data. And second is second method that is square root transformation and third inverse root transformation. Is it clear now? So I am repeating. First of all we check normality of our data. We estimate normality through KS test and p value should be greater than 0.05. We check homogeneity of the data through Levin test. P value should be greater than 0.05. In case we do not get a p value greater than 0.05, then it means our data not normal, not homogeneous. Then what should we do? So we should correct our data. So there are three ways to correcting our data. One is log transformation, the second is square root transformation, and third reciprocal transformation. Okay. Now this is the how to perform.
Kausal sir, sir, Mr. Govind, please stop the presenting. Please.
Govindan is presenting the screen.
Hello, sir.
Mr. Govindan, sir, kindly stop the presenting. It is a hello.
The same person is presenting the screen.
Yeah. Okay. Tillai Govindam, sir. Yeah. He was okay. Removed.
Okay, start. Kausal sir, start.
Sir, okay. So I am presenting again. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay, okay. Now, is it visible now? Please inform me.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you. So, how to find? How to transform the variable. So first of all we go to transform compute variable and then we enter the log here and then we will write the log 2 and then we will write this. So these are the way. So I will explain through the SPSS. Okay, so I am not explaining through the PPT. So this is the log transformation. I am showing the picture of the log transformation.
Sorry, sir. Again, your screen not visible.
Oh, Okay, okay. My
now it's visible, sir.
Is it visible or not?
Yes, sir. No visible.
Can you start the sharing and start again, sir?
Doctor Pandya.
Sir. ये गोविंदन सर के एंड से कहीं प्रॉब्लम हो रही है, उनको कहा जाए कि वो बार बार प्रेजेंट ना करें, इस वजह से आप डिस्टर्ब हो रहे हैं सर।
गोविंदन जी
प्लीज टेल, आई हैव रिमूव्ड हिम फ्रॉम द मीटिंग फॉर अ मोमेंट।
या
जॉइन एंड टेल। यस गोविंदन सर, प्लीज डोंट शेयर योर स्क्रीन, यू नीड नॉट टू डू दैट, इट्स क्रिएटिंग अ लॉट ऑफ डिस्टरबेंसेस।
अगेन ही इज प्रेजेंटिंग
सर, अगेन ही इज प्रेजेंटिंग।
गोविंदन सर, आर यू देयर? Everybody, let me talk to Govind. Tilai Govindam ji, are you there? Tilai Govindanam ji, are you there? Please respond.
Visible or not now?
Yes, sir. Visible.
Visible.
Okay.
Visible. Sorry for the disturbance.
Sir, before log transformation, my graph was like this. It is positively skewed. When I corrected my data through the log transformation, then distribution of the data like this. Okay. Now, second method is square root transformation. So through square root transformation, we correct our data. Before transforming, my data completely positively skewed, but after the square root transformation, we can see here our data more or less normally distributed bell shape. And third method inverse root transformation. So there are three methods of transform our data or correct our data, either log transformation, square root transformation, or inverse transformation. Okay. Now we understand the concept of the parametric and non-parametric test. So, sir, here we can see there are two graphs. One is parametric test and second is non-parametric test. So, parametric test means there are two sample. We can use parametric test for one sample, two sample, and more than two sample. So, first of all, we understand the meaning. We understand the meaning of the one sample, two sample, and more than two sample. What is the meaning of one sample, two sample, and more than two? Is it clear? So I am explaining. One sample means if we are taking one sample, means if we are analyzing only one variable at a time, one variable, then it is known as one sample. Or here two sample means two variables, but there are two group. One is y and second is that is dependent variable, and x that is independent variable. There are two group, two sample. Is it clear? So here two sample does not mean one sample from the Lucknow and second sample from the Delhi. Here two sample means whatever population of sample we have, we divide our sample into two mutually exclusive category. It means, for example, we have 100 participants in our FDP, then we divide this sample into the two, female and male. It means we create the two mutually exclusive category. So we can create our sample public sector, private sector, control group, or experimental group. Is it clear? So mutually exclusive group. So there are in the case of the independent t-test, so one that is this data metric and this one is non-metric data. There are two category, maybe female participants and male participants. So here we compare two means in the independent t-test. What do? We generally compare the two means. It means, for example, if I conduct the test on research methodology for this particular participants, means FDP program, so some male students and female students both are giving the examination of a research methodology program, and they obtain the numbers out of 100. Someone obtained 72, 73, 82, 83. Okay, so mean marks of the female participants and mean marks of the male. So we compare the mean marks of the we compare mean marks of two categories, or we can say comparing two means. When we compare two means, so we use independent t-test. If we compare more than two group, means we can divide our participant on the basis of the education background, science student, science education, commerce and arts, and then I compare who obtained the more marks, whether science students obtained more marks compared to other two groups, or arts student obtained more marks than to other group. So when there are more than two categories, more than two label, then we use analysis of variance. Is it clear? So this is the concept of the independent t-test. And paired t-test means when same respondent two times observe, means I am taking the weight of the 10 participants, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, I'm taking 10 participants and I am measuring the awareness score of the 10 participants, means before faculty development program and after faculty development program. Before faculty development program, score was 45, and after faculty development program, score increased 55. So here, 65 score 73. It means so we are treating, we are experiment something, and before treatment, and we same respondent, we are observing same respondent two times. Here we are not creating the two groups. Here we are taking observations two times, means before treatment and after treatment, and then we want to check the impact of this particular training program. If a score is increasing, we can say that the training program impacting students to enhancing their knowledge. Okay, so the basic difference between the independent two test and this paired t-test is this. Here we divide particular group into two categories on the basis of some characteristics. Characteristics may be public sector, private sector, male, female, high income, low income, occupation, private job, government job. We can divide our sample and then we compare two means. Is it clear? So paired t-test means, and the limitation of the paired t-test is this, we can compare only two times. We can observe two groups before treatment and after treatment. But if we want to take observation repeatedly, it means this 10 respondent after one FDP program, first was this, second FDP, after second FDP, after third FDP, and after four FDT, if we are taking the observations repeatedly, if you are taking observations repeatedly, is it clear? So if we are taking repeatedly measure, then this type known as the repeated measures ANOVA. Is it clear? So the basic repeated measures ANOVA, extension of the paired t-test. Limitation of the paired t-test is we can observe two times before treatment and after treatment. But in case if we want to take many observations same respondents, then we use repeated measures ANOVA. Same as a doctor can take the observation of 10 patients, means after 1 week, he can observe after 2 weeks, after 3 weeks, after 4 weeks, then in this case, we use repeated measures ANOVA. So before applying any statistical tools and technique, we should check our objective, what is our objective. And through on the basis of objective, we perform any statistical tool and technique. It doesn't mean that we collect data from the respondent and then we think that we want to analyze our data through ANOVA, we want to apply regression analysis, we want to apply discriminant analysis. No, because whatever statistical tool and technique we are using, it is completely depend on the our objectives. Our objectives decides the our objective decides which type of statistical tool and technique we should use. Okay, now this is this concept about the parametric test. Now second, non-parametric test. How the parametric tests are different differ from the parametric test. So in case of the parametric test, before applying any parametric test, we check the or we estimate the normality and homogeneity of our data. Is it clear? So if our data not normal, if our data not homogeneous, then we correct our data. There are three ways to correcting our data. One is data should be normal, data log transformation, square root transformation, and inverse transformation. Then we again perform the normality. We again estimate the normality and homogeneity. If our data normal and normal and homogeneous, then we can use we can apply independent t-test, PAT test, ANOVA, and repeated measures ANOVA. Now, if our after correcting our data, if our data not normally distributed, if our data not homogeneous, then what should I do? Now question is this. Now I have option. I have an option to use another test. These tests are non-parametric tests, are assumptions free test, or we can say distribution free test. If assumptions of the independent t test, if assumptions of the independent t test does not fulfill, then we use Mann-Whitney U test. It is equal to independent t test. Okay, in Mann-Whitney U test, again we compare two means, but here we will not compare two means because non-parametric test our data should be ordinal. So here we compare two median. We compare two median. Here we are comparing means here we compare rank, okay, or median. So here we use mean, but in case of non-parametric we use median value. So the everything means whatever assumptions we have checked in the parametric test, if we do not get normally and homogeneous data, then same thing we can get through the Mann-Whitney U test. We can apply Mann-Whitney U test. Generally what happens when our sample size is less, if sample size is less, so we do not get our data normally distributed. So generally what happens, our data, we don't get the bell shape of our data, and data not homogeneous for in case of less sample size, when sample size is less. So we use Mann-Whitney U test. But
sorry sir,
sir
hello,
your screen is not visible. Okay,
in your screen
Govindan sir is presenting the screen.
Sir please mute him. He doesn't know what is the function of that button.
Hello.
Tilay Govindan sir is not known.
Govindan sir.
Hello Patil. Yes.
Please stop your presenting.
Govindan sir, please stop
hello,
the presenting.
Hello participant. In fact, in between, just informing sir, you can do one thing. You can pin Salesh sir again so that you can you will be able to see his window. Despite informing him, you just please pin Shailesh sir window again. You will be able to see.
Can you see this slide?
Yes, sir.
It's visible.
Okay. I think doctor saab forget wo for bhul gaye hain apna wo screen karke shayad. Koi baat nahi.
Ah.
Okay. Now. So I am discussing about the Mann-Whitney U test. It is equivalent to the.
Sorry, sir.
Again,
he once again presenting the screen.
Doctor Govindan ji, are you there?
Please respond if you are there.
Sir, please sir, remove him.
Sir, kindly remove him because
yes, sir, I have removed him many times. I think he is unable to understand that he is creating a lot of problem. I'll just
excuse
call him right away. I'll just
excuse
give him
me,
a
sir.
Phone call. Yes.
Excuse me, sir. Yes, sir. This would be better. Maybe he's doing it unintentionally. He's not knowing the
yeah,
function.
I'll give you a call.
Sir. DJ, sir.
Make him. Okay. You people, please continue. Please continue.
Okay. Okay. Sir, slide. Is it visible, sir?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Visible.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
So, I was discussing about the Mann-Whitney U test. So if our assumptions do not fulfill, then we use the Mann-Whitney U test, which is equivalent to independent T test. And another test, Wilcoxon signed rank test. Again, it is same as pair T test, or we can say it is equivalent to pair T test, Wilcoxon signed rank test. What does this particular test do? Again, it is observing two times, means before this test also, before treatment and after treatment. In a Wilcoxon signed rank test, we are observing two times, before treatment and after treatment. It is same as pair T test. And for equivalent of ANOVA, so we will use Kruskal-Wallis test, and for equivalent of repeated measures ANOVA, we use Friedman's ANOVA. Is it clear? So if we are using Friedman ANOVA, it is not giving anything new. It is same as repeated measures ANOVA. Wilcoxon signed rank test, it is not new. It is just equivalent to pair T test. So we should not afraid to about the Wilcoxon signed rank test. It is not giving anything new, which is, it is only equivalent to pair T test. Kruskal-Wallis is not equivalent. It is not giving anything new. It is just equivalent to ANOVA. It means if we are using the I am using the Kruskal-Wallis test, it means my data not normally distributed, my data not homogeneous. That is why I am using Kruskal-Wallis test. If anyone using the Friedman ANOVA, I can ask him or her, why are you using this particular Friedman ANOVA? So he should have clear the his concept about the repeated measures ANOVA, and he or she should say, sir, I should use repeated measures ANOVA, but assumptions of this particular test does not fulfill. That is why I am using this Friedman ANOVA. Is it clear? So next slide, that is yes, sir.
Can I add a point?
Yes, sir. Yes.
I think Friedman's ANOVA is just an extension of pair T test.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If you want to apply pair T test but have many categories, then Friedman ANOVA would be better. Justified.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Now, thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Now, parametric test. I come to the parametric test. So, parametric test. There are. One is I.
Sorry, sir.
Hello.
He once again presenting
sir,
our screen.
So sorry to interrupt you. Again, there's a disturbance from the.
Okay. Same please person. Remove him. Please remove him.
Sir, we have removed him thrice.
Remove nahi kariye unko inform unko phone ke through inform.
Dr. Pandya, I have shared with you his number. Please call him.
Sir, okay, sir. उनको ये नहीं पता कि प्रेजेंट नाउ पे क्लिक करना है या फिर ज्वाइन इन पे, तो उन्हें ये ज्वाइन इन
पे आई थिंक ही इज डूइंग इट अनइंटेंशनली
कर रहे हैं. उनको फोन पे बता दीजिए सर, उनको उनको
डॉक्टर पांडे
हटाइए मत, उनको हटाइए मत, केवल उनको इन्फॉर्म.
यस सर, आई एम कॉलिंग हिम. सर, यस सर, आई एम कॉलिंग हिम.
हां हां, कॉल करके. नाउ इज इट विजिबल?
यस सर.
Okay, thank you. So I will use one sample T test, independent T test, pair T test, ANOVA, and repeated measures ANOVA. Okay, one sample T test. So one sample T test is
sir,
used
sorry,
to
sir,
test.
Sorry, sir.
Again, he is presenting.
Okay.
Yeah. If you have number, sir, if Pandit sir, if you have a number, directly contact me. Yeah, you send us some message to me, WhatsApp.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, I'm calling him.
We are contacting.
Is it visible?
Yes, sir, start.
Okay. Now, one sample t-test is used to test whether a population mean is significantly from some hypothesis value. Is it clear? Now, the variable should have, one is data are continuous, not discrete. It means data should be collected either interval or ratio scale. Then data should follow the normal distribution. Normal distribution means data should be normally distribution means ki data should be bell shape, and the sample is a sample, random sample from its population. Okay, now how to make the question for one sample t-test? My question, first thing is ki my data should be metric. Metric means data should be collected either interval or ratio scale, and I should prepare my question like this: how many kilometer run tires? Okay, this is the ratio scale, and here kilometer, 35,000 kilometer, 45,000 kilometer. So this may be my value. So I will use this case study to perform the one sample t-test. Here, this case study, a company X Tires has launched a new brand tires for cars and claims that under normal circumstances, the average life of tires is 40,000 kilometer. Okay. So the retailer claiming that his company tire will run 40,000 kilometer. Then he wanted to test the, so he took 10, a sample random of 10 tires, and life of first tire, that is 36,000, second tire life is 37,000, third tire 41, this is the observations. Now he is claiming the 40,000, okay. So I will explain through the case study, and I will perform with the help of SPSS. Second is independent t-test. So here independent t-test, this test is used to when there are two mutually exclusive group or experimental conditions, and different participants were assigned to each condition. It means here I already discussed you, there are two variable y and x. So here two group. So this test used to when there are two mutually exclusive group. Mutually means either male or female. Okay. So here two mutually exclusive group, or another group may be control group and experimental group. Is it clear? When we compare the two group, then we use independent t-test. And so here one variable should be nominal, means x should be categorical variable and y should be metric. Okay, metric or continuous variable. Now here we can see one independent variable, means one independent variable should be with two levels, or it is this particular variable should be nominal form, and metric data should be means dependent variable should be metric or continuous. Observation should be independent. These are the conditions of performing independent t-test. Now here we can see one is metric data, that is dependent variable, and x, that is independent variable, non-metric. And then we should prepare our one question like this: ki what is your gender, the male one, female two. And second question, how much salary are you drawing? Okay, so we can write here 40,000, 60,000, 1 lakh, 20,000, 40,000, whatever salary a male and female are getting, we will write here. So what will we do here? Here we will take, for example, and my hypothesis. There are two types of hypothesis: one null hypothesis and another alternate hypothesis. So my null hypothesis says there is no significant difference between the male and female getting salary in a public sector or private sector, जिसकी भी हम study कर रहे हैं. Okay, there is no significant difference. It means male and females are getting equal salaries. And in case of alternate hypothesis, it means there is a significant difference between getting salary by a particular, either male or female. So here we will take 10 observations of male teachers. So my hypothesis is the male teachers are getting higher salary than female teachers in a private sector. This is my hypothesis. So whether my my hypothesis is ki male teachers are getting higher salary than female teachers, whether I am right or wrong, so I will test through hypothesis. So what will I do? I will take the, this is the data of female, I will take the 10 female salary and take the mean. Okay, I will add first female salary, second female salary, and I will sum the salary and divide by number of observation. Same as I will take the salary of a male teacher 1, 2, 3. So I will, what is I am doing here, I am comparing the mean salary of two group, mean salary of, and we should keep in mind when we compare two group, always we will get the different value. Okay, but whether this difference is significant or not, p value tell us. P value should be less than 0.05. if p value less than 0.05, it means there is a significant difference. Significant difference means this is the male and this one female, the 40,000 and 50,000, one group 40,000, 60,000, 40,000, 70,000, 40,000, 80,000, all values are different. But which one is significant? Means significant means more. This is the significant difference, 40. When we compare any two means, we always get the different value. But whether this difference, this particular difference, significant or not, who will tell us? This p value tell us. If p value less than 0.05, it means there is a significant difference between the salary getting by the either male or female. Okay, now so after this I will explain the next, that is paired t test, concept of a paired t test. So I will use this particular case study to explain the independent t test. Okay, it is very simple case study. So my case study is this: two example to know whether the salary of male faculty members in private sector is equal to salary of female faculty members. Researcher collected data from 20 male and 20 female faculty members in a private sector to know the difference. Is it clear? So here there are two variable, dependent variable that is salary and independent variable that is gender. So male and female, and salary that is dependent variable in metric form, independent variable male female it is non-metric form. Okay, now this is about the independent t-test. Now second, pair t-test. Pair t-test means when we observe same respondent two times, means before treatment and after treatment, means before this is our experiment or manipulation. Okay, so we use pair t-test. The paired sample t-test compares two means that are from the same individual, object or related unit. that are means can represent things like a measurement taken two different times, pre-test and post-test, and intervention administered between the two time of points. Okay, so here I already discussed you the we observe two times means, and data should be metric form, continuous data, and pre-test and post-test observations of the same object means same respondent should be same, or object should be same respond. We are taking two times observations, one before treatment and second after treatment. Okay, now this is the case study of a pair t-test. I will use to this case study to perform the pair t-test. Case study is ABC University arranged a special faculty development program for one segment of its teacher. The university wants to measure the change in the attitude of its teachers after the FDP. Okay. For this purpose, it is used to a well-designed questionnaire which consists of 10 questions, strongly disagree to strongly Likert scale question. Now, the university selected at a random sample of 20 teachers. Okay. So here, the metric data, that is dependent variable. And so before training, the score of first participants was 25, and after training program, score increased 38. Then means same respondent score 35 and after training 45. So our data, we should create table like this to perform the this particular paired t-test. Okay. Now next is analysis of variance. Okay, analysis of variance. This test useful to analyze situations in which we want to compare more than two condition means what is more than two condition?
Interruption, sir. Actually, t-test, it is the measurement skills which are used at least the interval observation drawn from the normal distributed. So in the t-test, now we can use the total, not more than 30 sample we can use.
yes sir. Can you repeat, sir, again?
Actually, t-test, you can apply it for the t-test if the measurement scale used are at least interval observations and drawn from the normal distributed populations. Okay. So in this case, if you are using the t-test, then the sample size population not more than the 30 samples. So we can use a t-test or a z-test. Better you can get the results, t-tails test, and also two-tail test.
Okay. Sir, in SPSS, if my sample size 10, 30, 40, 100, then we, hello, sir. In SPSS, we analyze a t-test for comparing two means, and it doesn't matter whether our sample size is less than 30 or 40 or more than 100, 200, 300. Is it clear? Now, when in SPSS, if sample size less than 30, 10, 20, 30 or greater than 30, we use t-test. So here we sometimes in a theoretical in books, we can go through the books, we can see the if sample size less than 30, then we use t-test. If more than this, we use z-test. But here in a SPSS, there is no option of J test. Whatever be the sample size, we if we are comparing two means, we use T test. Okay. Now second is
sir, actually, if the sample size is more than 30 in T test, so whatever we have fed the all the respondent in the SPSS, the SPSS we can get the output. But in theoretically, we know that if the in the time of the question of preparation and we getting the pilot study, so we go for the T-test in the time of total, we have to check the our question series is valid or not. So that's why we have to use the measurement skill of the T-test. Not more than 30.
I think this concept of if sample size is more than 30, then conduct jet test, else conduct T-test, only applies for one sample t-test where you compare whether your population mean and sample mean are different or they are equal, only in case of one sample, and that only we do during the pre-testing. For independent sample t-test or pair t-test, this concept of 30 sample size or more than that doesn't apply.
Okay,
can you see this slide, Enova?
Yes sir.
Okay, thank you sir. Now, ANOVA means this test useful to analyze situation in which we want to compare more than two conditions. It means more than two conditions means theoretically unlimited, like one that is dependent variable and another independent variable means three. It means more than two. More than two means level may be 3, 4, 5 theoretically, but generally we take 4 or 5 level. Okay, so here level, there are, if we here what are we are doing here, we are comparing several means. In case of independent t-test, we are comparing two means, but here we are comparing several means, one mean, two mean, three means and four means, and we want to check the impact of particular label. Is it clear which particular label is impacting more to the dependent variable? So analysis of variance, we can say it is the extension of the independent t-test. Limitation is this, the independent t-test we can apply only for two labels, and independent t-test theoretically unlimited labels. Okay, now one independent variable more than two labels means three labels, four labels, and dependent variables should be metric or continuous dependent variable. And again, third condition, observation should be independent. So before applying any analysis of variance, we should keep in mind three conditions, means dependent variable should be nominal and more than two categories, metric, dependent variable should be metric, and score should be, observation should be independent to each other. Now case study here, I will take this particular case study to explain an experiment in which a major department store chain wanted to examine the effect of level in store promotion. The experimenter wants to know the impact of in store promotion in sales. Okay, he is in five outlet. He is not performing any promotion. Now, five outlets, departmental store, medium promotion. It means he is giving 20% discount, and some five departmental store, he is giving 30%. Okay, so there are three types of promotion: no discount, 20% discount, and 30% discount. And he wanted to know which type of promotion more effective to increase the sales. So here, no promotion, five outlets, medium promotion, five departmental store, and this particular dependent variable should be metric and nominal, independent variable should be nominal. Okay, now next is repeated measures ANOVA. Repeated measures ANOVA used to compare three or more groups means where the participants are the same. It means here in a repeated measures ANOVA, for example, I am taking five participants, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I want to give treatment to the 5 participants, and after treatment the weight of the participants 78, 80, 73, 50, 58, and 60. Okay, and after first treatment the score 75, 73, 60, and so on. And secondary after treat third second treatment score like this. So here we compare three or more group means where the participants are same in each group. The participants are same. Okay. So this type of analysis known as the repeated measures ANOVA, because we are repeatedly measuring the same respondent more than 2 times. So this is repeated measures ANOVA. So this is my case study. The dietitian introduced new diet chart plan to reduce weight loss. The dietitian took 15 women who considered themselves to be in need of losing weight and put them on this diet for 2 months. Their weight was measured in kilograms at the start of the diet, and then after 1 month, 2 month, after 3 months. Okay, so 15 dietitian, and we are taking the same observation 3 times. Okay, now I am performing these 5 tests through SPSS, and I am opening the SPSS here. I think you can see SPSS. I think is it visible to you? Can you see, sir, this SPSS?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. One sample t-test. This is my data. Tires, I discussed about the tires, the first tire of this. So I am performing here this. So first of all, I should check the normality of the data, whether this data normally distributed or not. Okay. So before applying, I should check. I will take the example of the normality and homogeneity. Okay, so how to check the normality and homogeneity of the data. So I am taking the first of all, I will check the normality and homogeneity of the data. This is my data. So how to estimate the normality and homogeneity of the data? Okay, so for normality, I will first of all I will correct my data. So actually case number edit 682, I think data. This is okay. Now I am checking the normality and homogeneity. How will I check? First of all, I go to analyze, then descriptive statistics, and explore. Okay, now the normality of the data, I will select all the 3 values simultaneously, and I can take one by one also. Dependent, and I go to statistics. By default, it will give descriptive, means whenever I talk about descriptive, it means central tendency, measures of dispersion, and distribution. Okay, then continue. Plots, histogram, I need normality. This is for KS test. Okay, KS test. And then so I will get 3 result. One is a graph, means histogram. Through histogram we can estimate the normality of the data. Second, descriptive statistics,
means value of skewness kurtosis, and third method KS test. So normality plot with test continue, and then next options here we can see some missing values in day 2 and day 3. So I will correct it, exclude cases pairwise, and then continue and last. Okay, so I will get the result. So now I think this is visible to all. So here we can see the first day 800 participants were there, second day 262, third day 182. Now we can check the homogeneity through histogram. So day 1 data more or less normally distributed. I will double click it, and elements I want to superimpose the normal curve, and then show normal distribution curve, and then okay. So I will get this graph. This is more or less normally distributed. Is it visible? Hello?
Yes, sir.
But voice coming from someone.
I would request Kamlesh Kaur madam to switch off the video.
This is my second day data. This is second day data, and this is not normally distributed. It is not looking normally distributed, and we can see this data. Not and day 3 data. This is my day 3 data.
Sir, in the background.
Hello. Now it's okay. Now it's okay. Now there is no voice. Okay, and this is my day 3 data. Okay, so I have 3 days data. Day one data that is normally distributed. Day 2 data not normally distributed. Day 3 data not normally distributed. So through histogram we can see our data not normally distributed. Second, through graph, the data, it is more or less normally distributed. It is not much deviate from the principal diagonal. And day 2, it is taking shape of a curve. So it is not normally distributed, and this is again not normally distributed. Okay, second method, that is the value of skewness and kurtosis. In day 1, the skewness value minus 0.004 and kurtosis value minus 0.408. It means our data normally distributed. We earlier we identified that through graph histogram we identified that our data normally distributed. Okay, and through second method, that is the value of skewness, again it is between the minus 1 and plus 1. So day 2 data, what is the skewness? That is 1.08 plus, and kurtosis 0.78. but
sorry. Hello? Sir,
yes sir.
Sir, कोई दूसरा बंदा जो अभी प्रेजेंट कर रहा था स्क्रीन.
अच्छा अच्छा अच्छा, तो अभी मैं फिर से कर लेता हूँ सर. Now it's, is it visible sir?
Yes sir.
Okay, thank you. Now I'm repeating again, day 1 day is
screen. Yes sir, visible.
Okay, thank you sir. The day 1, the value of
it's visible sir.
Sir, एक मिनट, let me clear. Admin can ऐसा कोई बंदा आ रहा है जो अपने आप को, तो आप उससे आप left भी कर सकते हैं सर, क्योंकि एक sequence बना हुआ है सर, और उसमें काफी बार disturbance आ जाता है.
सर उनको लीव करने के बाद समटाइम्स दे कम बैक.
हां पर सर ये बार बार क्या, क्योंकि एक बार हम पूरा ये स्टैटिस्टिकल एनालिसिस है, उसमें कोई और बंदा आ जाता है ना तो डिस्टर्बेंस आ जाता है सर. और कोई बात?
आई एग्री.
थैंक यू.
ओके सर, आई एम अगेन रिपीटिंग सेम थिंग. फर्स्ट इज ग्राफ, थ्रू हिस्टोग्राम वी कैन सी डे 1 डेटा इज नॉर्मली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड. थ्रू graph histogram, day 2 data not normally distributed, again day 3 data not normally distributed. Second way to identify the whether our data normally distributed or not, value of skewness and kurtosis. here value we can see it is between minus 1 and plus 1. So day 1 data is normally distributed. Day 2 data, it is 1.081, not normally distributed. And day 3 data, again, value of skewness 1.022. Again, it is outside the range. So through graph and value of skewness and kurtosis, we understood that day 1 data is normally distributed. Now we confirm through the test and third method, that is the KS test. And p-value, that is the significant. This particular p-value should be greater than 0.05. And our value is 19.3%. Okay, so it is greater than 5%, means 0.1935. So I told you that our data, this particular value, our value, this particular value should be greater than 0.05. And here we can see this particular value greater than 0.05. It means it is 19.5%, or we can say 0.195. It is desirable for our study. Here we can see the value of p, that is the less than 0.05. So it is not desirable, and this is not desirable. So we have through histogram we know that our data normally distributed, and through value of skewness and kurtosis again we found that our data normally distributed, because value of skewness and kurtosis between the minus 1 and plus 1. And through KS test again we found that our data normally distributed, because p value greater than 0.05. okay, now we check the homogeneity of our data. How to check the homogeneity of our data? I'm taking same example to check the homogeneity of our data. Okay, homogeneity can be checked only when we have minimum two groups. If we have one group, we cannot check the homogeneity of our data. Now the same data I am using to check the homogeneity of the data. I will go to analyze, and simultaneously I will perform normality and homogeneity. Okay, so analyze, descriptive statistics, explore, and all the variables I have transferred into the dependent list box, and gender into the factor list. So I will slightly change here in a plot for normality. By default, I earlier ticked here normality plot with test, and for live-in test, okay, here I am ticking here untransformed. So I will get two results, one for p-value of normality and p-value for another test, live-in test. Okay, so I will continue here, and then okay, so I will get the result, value of skewness and kurtosis. So it is opening. So I will see only the KS test value and as well as live-in test value. Okay, so here we can see the this particular male and female data, distribution of the male data, that is the normally distributed, and female data not normal distributed, not normal distributed, not normal distributed. And day 3 male data normally distributed, because p value greater than 0.05. okay, now here we can see only this is desirable. And here again the p value, that is, what is p value? It is less than 0.05. so here it is not desirable. It means our data not normal and not homogeneous, because every value should be greater than 0.05. so here for finding the homogeneity of the data, here for, based on the mean, that is the 0.030, and it is 0.003, and it is 0.001. it is not homogeneous, it is not homogeneous. Okay, so we understood normality and homogeneity. Finally, we should check or report the value of the test of normality and test of the homogeneity of the variance. Okay, so after this break, I'm taking for 10 minutes break, and after break I will take the case study of the one sample t-test, independent sample and pair t-test, ANOVA and other test also. Okay, so we will meet again 7:40. आप इसको छोड़िएगा मत, इसी पे रहिए जिससे कनेक्टिविटी बनी रहे.
प्लीज डोंट लीव द मीटिंग, स्टे ट्यून्ड टू द ग्रुप. जस्ट 10 मिनट्स बैक.
हेलो हेलो
हेलो
हाँ जी सर स्टार्ट कर रहे हैं
यस सर यू कैन स्टार्ट सर
ओके ओके
पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर देयर
Sir, can I ask a question?
Yes.
Sir, my question is, when we have a high skewness or high kurtosis in the result, can we go back to the data sheet and remove those variables that are causing the high skewness or kurtosis?
No, no. We will not remove the variable. We will remove the cases.
Yes, sir. I mean, removing the cases. I mean, removing the cases.
Yes. This is the one method to correct our data.
Sir, so we then how do you know? Outlier.
So through box plot, we can identify the particular outliers. Yesterday, I told you.
Sir, recently you asked remove the cases, but sir, if the experimental research or survey research. So okay. if I remove the cases, means what the impact of that particular research?
Sir, if we have large sample size, then there is no impact. Okay, if sample size is less, then if we do not want to remove the particular, like outlier, if we have outlier, it will be removed from our data in any case. And no, if
one minute for the interruptions, sir. Well, large sample it is okay, but how many cases? Suppose in my case, suppose my research, my data, they affect the kurtosis and skewness. For example, 50 cases. For example, okay. In the large in way. So can I remove 50? So if I remove 50 numbers of cases, so it is obviously the impact of my total research. And their findings.
Okay, sir, I am talking about outliers. So if your outlier, outlier 50, it is not possible you have 50 or 40 outlier. Outlier may be 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so if you have outlier first.
But sir, as per SPSS, the outliers already removed.
No, that's okay.
If you in the less quantity.
Okay.
It, 2, 3 is not a part.
Okay. If you already remove the outlier, then second, we correct our data for reducing the skewness. We transform our data either log transformation, square root transformation, or inverse transformation. There are the three methods to remove the skewness of the data.
Okay.
Now I start my lecture with the. Parametric test, one sample t-test. Okay, this is my case study, and here we can see the Now here the data of 10 responses, 10 observations. Now
sir, can you please present again, sir? Screen is not visible.
Okay, sir. Again. Still resume your screen.
Yes, sir. Now it is visible, sir.
Now visible. Thank you. No, sir. Thank you, sir. Now, this is my case study of tires. The retailer claimed that this company tire will run 40,000 kilometers. Okay. Now, he took 10 observations. First tire life 36,000 kilometers, second 37,000 kilometers, and so on. So, I will apply one sample t-test, analyze, compare means, and one sample t-test. So this is the way to perform the one sample t-test. I will transfer life of the tire in test variable and test value. I will write here 40,000 kilometer. Okay, this is the 40,000 kilometer. This is the population mean, and my sample mean should represent the population mean. If it is away from the 40,000, then his claim is not right. Now options, then continue, and then okay. Now this is my result of one sample t-test. Here the mean value of my sample, that is 40,100.
Sorry to interrupt you, sir. Screen is not visible.
Okay, again I'm trying. No. Now, is it visible?
No, visible.
Okay.
No, thank sir, you. It's not visible.
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Not visible.
Ma'am, please it's check your internet sir. Connection.
Visible, sir.
Okay, sir, thank you. If it now, if I think it is visible to all. Right? Now, life of tire, that is the mean value of the 10 observation, that is 40,100. And here we will check the P value. And what is the P value? That is the 0.885. Our null hypothesis that there is no significant difference between the sample mean and population mean. It means whatever claim he is doing, it is right. And if this particular mean value away from the population mean value, then we say that his claim was wrong. So here it means we assume that there is no significant difference between the sample mean and population mean, and p value tell us whether the significant difference was exist or not. Okay. Now I am taking the case study of independent t-test. Independent t-test, that is the this is my data of independent t-test. This is my data. Okay. In this particular case study, I discussed that I want to test whether the male salary significantly different from the female or not. Okay, so I have taken 40 respondent. Out of 40, 20 male and 20 female. So what will I do here? I will take the mean value of the salary of 20 males and mean value of the female, 20 female. Okay, so I will compare the two means, mean value of the male and mean value of the female. So I am performing the independent t-test. Analyze my means my hypothesis is there is no significant difference between the getting salary by male and female teachers. Okay, now I perform an independent t-test, analyze, compare means, and independent sample t-test. Okay, Now, what is your gender? I will transfer it into the grouping variables. Then define groups. Define groups. So there are two groups, and two groups means the one group that is one coding. I have coded one for male and two for female. So here, what will I do? I will put one for male and two for female, group two. Okay, this is simply coding. And then continue, salary of teacher into the test variable box, options, nothing to do, continue, and then finally, okay. And I will tick okay. This is my result. Salary of teachers, I told you when we compare two means, always we will get the two different value. Here value is 49,900, here female value 39,400. Okay, this is different. But whether this particular value significantly different from each other or not, T value tell us. Okay, here this is our T value, that is 4.088, and P value 0.00. Okay, this is less than 0.05. It means there is a significant difference between the two means. My hypothesis was, now I can check my hypothesis. So my hypothesis, there are two hypotheses. First hypothesis, that is the null hypothesis. Null hypothesis means null hypothesis. Here null hypothesis, there is no significant difference. Okay, and alternate hypothesis, there is a significant difference. So we confirm this alternate hypothesis, except because p value less than 0.05. so here we can see the p value less than 0.05, and this is our t value, degree of freedom, n minus 2. Okay, so this is about the independent t-test. Now I am taking another case, that is a paired t-test. Paired t-test, I will use the case study of paired t-test case study. So paired t-test, paired t-test. So this is my means before faculty development program, we collected data of 20 participants. One organization means ABC University sent their 20 teachers into the particular faculty development program. So before training program, so we write our data this way. So if we are applying paired t-test, our data should be like this, before treatment and after. Okay, now analyze. I will go to analyze, and then compare means and paired sample t-test. Okay, so I will transfer both the variable one by one, before faculty development program and after faculty development program, and options, continue, and okay. So this is my output. The first table shows about the mean value of the score of 20 participants. Before faculty development program, the mean value was 24.75, and after the faculty development program, 33.25. It means there is a difference, but whether this particular difference significant or not, e value tell us. Okay, now we can see here the difference.
Sorry, sir.
Hello.
Sorry, sir. Another person presenting our screen right now.
Okay. So I will present again.
Okay, sir.
Now, is it visible? Can you see this screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. So I am again repeating. Thank you, sir. I am again repeating. The before faculty development. Hello. before faculty development, before faculty development program, the mean score 24.75, and after faculty development program the score is 33.25. It means there is difference, it is not same, but whether this difference significant or not, who will tell us? This p value, last three column we see here, this is our t-test value, AT test value minus 7 point this, and degree freedom and p value 0.000. It means our null hypothesis reject and alternate hypothesis accept. It means there is impact of training program of the we can say faculty development program enhances the knowledge of the faculty members. Okay, so this is about the pair t test. Now I am taking the case study of analysis of variance. Third case study, analyze, then compare means, and one way ANOVA. Okay, so analyze, compare means, one way ANOVA, and then first of all I will open the file data ANOVA. This is ANOVA. Okay, this is my file. So here five departmental store, there is no promotion, and the sale per day sale was 2 lakh 50,000, 2 lakh, 1 lakh 50,000, 3 lakh 50,000. Okay, so here what will we do? We will compare three means, more than two means. It means we are comparing several means, means no promotion, mean of medium promotion, and mean of high promotion. Okay, so this is no promotion. Now we can say when we are nothing to, we are not doing anything, then our sales of this, if we are giving 20% discount to our products, then sale increased, and then high promotion, sale of the five departmental store is this. Okay, so I will apply the analysis of variance. How will I perform? So I will go to analyze, then compare means, and one way ANOVA. Okay, this is the path to analyze or perform the one way ANOVA. And then sales promotion, it is factor categorical variable here. Sales are in the dependent list, contrast, nothing to do here. Post-hoc analysis, Bonferroni, and then options, the descriptive homogeneity, and we can create mean plots also, and then continue. This is my output of analysis of variance. When we are not doing promotion, the mean salary 2 lakh 50,000. Hello?
Yes, sir. Sir, kindly repeat once.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
This is okay. When we are not doing any promotion, there is no promotion, the mean sales of the five departmental store here 2 lakh 50,000. When we are giving 20% discount means 20% discount, then sales increase, we can see here 4 lakh 50,000, high promotion 5 lakh 60,000. Okay, so there is a difference, we can see, but whether this difference significant or not, ANOVA table tell us. Here we can see the p value, that is less than 0.05. it means there is a significant difference between the several means. Okay, jo to teen mean hai, three means in kinder, we can see this significant difference, but we do not know which particular level impacting to increase the sales. So through this, there are three pairs. We will compare three. One, no promotion with medium, no promotion, high promotion, and medium promotion, high promotion. So post-hoc analysis tell us about the which particular pair is impacting. Okay,
when we compare no promotion with medium promotion, here p value, that is 0.009. it means if we do a medium promotion, so there is a significant rise in the sales of our product or services. When no promotion with high promotion, then we see there is a significant difference between the between the two, means no promotion and high promotion. It means high promotion also increase the sales, and then medium promotion and high promotion, there is no difference. Okay, so we can see here, if there is no promotion, the mean sales 250,000. If we increase medium promotion and high promotion, if we perform medium and high promotion, our sales significantly increase. Okay, now next that is case study related to the repeated measures ANOVA. This is repeated measures ANOVA. So this particular case study, here we can see the weight, means one dietitian claimed that he will reduce the weight of 10 participants. Okay, so baseline weight that is 63.75 kg, and after 1 month weight 65.38, and after 2 months weight 81.34. Now second participant's weight, it increase 69.31, and then third. So we can see here only fourth participant weight reducing 107 to 102, 91. Again we can see only very few participants weight are reducing, otherwise maximum people weight increasing. Okay, so now this particular dietitian are claiming that her or his training program would be effective to reduce the weight. Now we will check it. So we will apply repeated measures ANOVA, because we are taking observation more than three times we are taking observations. So here we use repeated measures ANOVA, analyze, GLM, general linear model, repeated measures, and this is factor. So and there are three levels, and add and then define weight. So we will shift all the three, transfer all the three weights into here, and then model, continue, contrast, polynomial, and then repeated, then change, continue, plots, no need, then options, we will transfer overall, and factor, compare manifest, and SEDEC, descriptive statistics, estimates of effect size, transformation matrix, and then continue. And after continue, we will okay. So before joining this program, the mean weight was 78 point this. After 1 month, 77 point this. After 2 months, so it is different. But whether it is significant or not, who will tell us? The p value tell us. So here test of sparsity assumed and this. So we can see here there is no significant difference, because p value it is greater than 0.05. okay, so there is no impact. And through data we can also see there is no significant there is weight is not significantly reducing. Okay, so this is all about the repeated measures ANOVA. Now I am taking the non-parametric test. So non-parametric test, So what non-parametric tests are those tests which do not rely on data belonging to any particular parametric family or probability distribution. It means these tests are distribution free tests. It means we do not check normality and homogeneity of our data. Now question is, when to use non-parametric test? Non-parametric tests are used when assumptions of parametric tests are not met. Okay, so when do we use non-parametric? When assumptions of the parametric test. And what are the assumptions of parametric test? When our data not normally distributed, when our data not homogeneous, then we correct our data through log transformation, square root transformation, inverse transformation, and then check again normality and homogeneity of the data. If our data not normal, not homogeneous, then we use non-parametric test. Okay, so non-parametric test, we for one sample we use Wilcoxon rank sign test. For two sample, it is Mann-Whitney U test, which is equivalent to the independent two test. Wilcoxon rank sign test to dependent sample means two paired, it is equivalent to paired two test. And Kruskal values, which is equivalent to the analysis of variance, and Friedman ANOVA, and that is equivalent to repeated measures ANOVA. Okay.
Excuse me, sir. In the previous slide, as can be seen, it means that Wilcoxon sign rank test is used for paired t test as well as one sample test in case of non parametric. Maneki, Wilcoxon sign rank test is both one sample as well as paired t test. It is non
parametric. We can use for non metric data for one sample and as well as two sample also.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Now, one sample Wilcoxon rank sign test. So this is my case study of I will perform this test. The test is State Bank of India manager indicates that median number of saving account customer per day is 53. Okay. And a clerk from the same branch claimed that it was more than 53. So clerk collected the number of saving account customers per day. So this is ordinal data. So it means day 1 50, day 2 50, 3 55, day 3 54, day 4 59. So although this data is continuous, okay, so you can see the number of customers. These numbers are ratio scale data, means data may be 0, data may be 100, 200. So data is continuous, but when we check the normality and abnormality of the data, this data is not normally distributed. So we use a non-parametric test because this particular data not normally distributed. Okay, then Mann-Whitney U test, which is equivalent to the independent T test. The Mann-Whitney U test is a non-parametric test that can be used in place of an unpaired t-test. Unpaired t-test ka matlab hai independent t-test. It is used to test the null hypothesis that two sample come from the same population or same median. Here we will use the term median in here non-parametric test. We do not use the term mean value. Okay, alternatively, whether observation in one sample tend larger than the observation in other. This is the theory of the Mann-Whitney U test. Here one independent variable, it is same as the independent t test. Independent t test means one variable should be two level, means categorical variable and another variable either ordinal or continuous. Even if we have continuous variable, if we use continuous variable and then we check the normality of the data and our data not normal, then we can use the non-parametric test. Okay, so our data should be either ordinal or continuous, and nominal data that is the two category. There may be two category. Now this is the score of the case study. The test in this lecture work on principle of ranking of data for each group. Lowest score, we put lowest score of one rank and highest score rank two. Okay, so if we are using continuous data, so this non-parametric test convert this continuous data into ordinal data. It means it will convert this into the ranking data. So I am taking the example of bag depression inventory. Again, this is this case study. I have taken this case study from the ND field book, Discovering of Statistics. So if you want to know more detail, so you go through this particular book. It is very good book. Now here, what is case study? A neurologist investigated the depression effect of certain recreational drug, tested 20 clubbers. Okay, 20 clubbers means 20 people who are feeling the depression, and 10 the neurologist divide 20 clubbers into two. 10 was given an ecstasy tablet for 10 patients. This neurologist has given the tablet, and 10 for 10 participants, neurologist said you should take alcohol, 3 or 4 peg of alcohol, and then you tell us next day whether your depression level decrease or not. Okay, so there are two group, 10 people, this particular neurologist give the tablet, and another 10 people he told that drink alcohol only. Okay, now so here this is the score of we will take the score of ecstasy tablet, 10 people, and drink alcohol. Okay, so this neurologist has given ecstasy tablet to 10 people, and we will note the score, depression score of 10 patients, we can say, and drink alcohol 10 patients. So here we will not compare the means, we will compare the median. Okay, median value. Earlier in case of parametric test, we compare the mean value of two groups, but here we will not compare the mean value of two groups, we will compare the median value. Okay, so there are two variables, dependent variable that is ordinal, independent variable that is nominal. Okay, so depression score that is, it is continuous score, but our assumptions do not fulfill, that is why this score will convert into the ordinal score. Now, how will we convert the score? This is the data of this is the data. The first participant score is depression score is 3, second participant score is 5, third participant score 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on. Now we are tested two times. Saturday night we performed the Saturday night. We have given the tablet to the 10 persons, and drink alcohol. We told them you drink alcohol, 10 people. Okay. So Saturday night we have treated them, and next day, Sunday morning, we observed the data. And we repeated 3 days, and after 3 days also we observed the data, means Wednesday. So first of all, I am taking the next day data, means Sunday data. The first participant data, so there are 20 participants. So first day data is 13, second participant data 14, 15, 15, 16, 16. Okay, this is the data of 20 respondent. So here A means alcohol, E means ecstasy tablet. This data of alcohol group people, and E means ecstasy tablet group people. So here we have coded here, you can see. So I told you that we will make the rank. Whose score is less, we will give the rank 1 here. And score is tie, So one and two. So we will give distribute three and divide by two, 1.5 and 1.5. And this is the rank 3, 4, 5, 6, because there are the three tie score. So we will add them, and 15 divided by 3, 5, 5, 5, 8.5, 8.5, and this is okay. So ranking, this is this score, it is, or SPSS will convert this data into the ranking, ordinal data. Okay, now we can take the mean of rank. Here we are taking the sum of rank, means alcohol group, alcohol 1.5 and plus 3 plus 5 plus 5 plus 8.5 plus 8.5 plus 13 plus 13 plus 15.5 plus 17.5. so our sum of rank of alcohol group is 90.5, and a acetic tablet, when we add all the, what is the score? 119.5. so we can see here the sum of rank of alcohol group and as well as acetic tablet. So this is score of after one day, means Sunday score, and after 3 day score, the when we the particular neurologist giving the tablets to continuously Sunday, Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday, we observe the score. The mean rank of the alcohol group, that is the 59, and the sum of rank of acetic group is 151. Okay, so we can convert, or SPSS will automatically convert this continuous data into the ranking data. We do not need to convert data. Now second method, that is Wilcoxon signed ring rank test. So this test to compare two sets of score, it is same as a paired T test. Okay, when these scores come from the same participants, so two compare sets of a score, it means these data come from the same participant two times, means before treatment and after treatment. Imagine the experimenter in previous example was interested to change in depression level of for each of the two groups. Now of two groups, so here we can see the same group. A neurologist investigated the depression effect of certain recreational drugs. Okay, so this is recreational. The value of this ecstasy, 10 people from the ecstasy tablet group and 10 people from the 10 people from the alcohol group. So here what will we do? We will we want to apply Wilcoxon ranks and test. It means same 10. So we will perform the two times, means 10 respondent, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 10. Okay, so Saturday night we have given tablet to the 10 people, and Sunday score that is, for example, 3, 12, 17 and so on, and Wednesday score is 7, 13 and so on. So here we are we will have same data, we will use for Wilcoxon rank sign t test. Okay, so for we can check pair t test, equivalent of pair t test Wilcoxon for acetic tablet users and for drink alcohol users. So for same data we can test the Wilcoxon rank sign test, whether if we are giving the tablet continuously for 3 days, whether the depression level increase or decrease. Okay, same as we compare two times same respondent, Sunday score and as well as Wednesday score, whether the drink alcohol reduce the depression level score or not. Okay, so this is about the Wilcoxon rank sign t test, and next test, which is next test, that is this is the score, okay, back depression, this ecstasy tablet, the Sunday score of first participant 15 and after 3 days score was 28, 35, 35, 30, 16, 35. So when we observe two times same respondent, so we will use here Bell Coxman rank sign test. So we can perform two times, one for ecstasy tablet group and another for drink alcohol group. Okay, so this, so we can perform two times Bell Coxman rank sign T test. This is the basically the difference, the theory behind the Bell Coxman rank sign test. This is the BDI score, back depression inventory score of Sunday. This is the Wednesday score. This difference, and then the sign plus and minus. We add all sign, positive and negative. There is no negative rank. Okay, and then same as this, and we put all the value in the formula. If you want to go through in detail, you can go through the discovering of statistics by Andy Field book. Okay, so next test, that is the Kruskal-Wallis test. Kruskal-Wallis test, that is Kruskal-Wallis test, it is a non-parametric test and counterpart of one-way independent ANOVA. Okay, if you have data that if you have data validated and assumption that this test can be useful way around the problem. We have earlier discussed that if assumptions of the one-way independent ANOVA test are not fulfilled, then we use the equivalent of this, that is the Kruskal-Wallis test. Okay, now this is my case study, I will perform it. So there are two variable, one outcome variable, heart rate score, and coffee, number of coffee per day. So we want to know whether consumption of coffee consumption increases the heart rate or not. So we want to check the impact of coffee consumption on heart rate score. So here we can see independent variable, number of coffees, no coffee per days, no coffee per days means here we can see 10 participants participated in this study. It means we are not giving coffee of 10 participants and we are measuring their heart rate score. Someone heart rate score 73, 78, 82, 68, and so on. Now, second group, we are giving them one cup coffee per day and they, we are measuring their score then 75, 78, and so on. Now, another group, 10 people, and we are giving them two cup of coffee and we are measuring the their score like 78, 73, and these are the heart rate score. And for another group, we are giving four cup coffee per day and we are measuring the score like 88, 92, and so on. So we want to know whether this, whether one cup coffee, two cup coffee, or four cup coffee increase the heart rate score significantly. If one cup coffee are in, hello,
sorry, yes. Sir.
So the is not on the screen. Visible.
Mr.
Hello, sir.
Sunil Gawandeji. Hello.
Hanji, sir.
Dr. Sunil. Sir, actually, your presentation is not visible.
Okay. I understood.
Yeah.
Hello. Hello,
Dr. Sunil, kindly remove yourself from the presentation.
My presentation.
Is it visible, sir?
Yes, sir.
Now it is visible.
Now, okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Now,
sorry, so, sir, your presentation is not visible.
Not visible.
Sir,
is it visible or not?
Yes, sir, it is visible now.
Thank you. Thank you. Now, no cup coffee per day. So here we will compare means no cup coffee per day, 1 cup coffee per day, 2 cup coffee per day, and 4 cup coffee per day. And we want to check which particular level impacting more to increase the heart rate score. Okay, so this is my case study here. This case study basically now how to prepare our data for conducting the Kruskal Wallis test. So our data should like this. One variable, that is the independent variable, should be categorical variable. Here 4 category: no cup coffee, 1 cup coffee, 4 cup coffee. Okay, so we will take the values of all 4 groups, and then data, ordinal data, we required ordinal data. If our data is continuous, then SPSS automatically convert into the ordinal data. Okay, so here dependent variable heart rate score, actually it is a ratio scale data, but data if why are we using this data? Because our data not normally distributed or homogeneous, that is why we can take continuous data. Okay, now it will change. Ye change hoga data hamara. Now the post hoc analysis test. Now in the case of the analysis of variance, we have option to conduct post hoc analysis test. But in case of non-parametric test, we cannot conduct post hoc analysis test. So what will we do? We will make 3 pair. Okay, we will compare 1 cup coffee. We will perform 3 times Mann-Whitney test. 1 group, 1 cup coffee with no cup coffee, 2 cup coffee, no cup coffee, 4 cup coffee, and no cup coffee. It means we if we get the p value less than 0.05, it means there is a significant difference, but we do not know which particular group is giving the significant significant result. So here we will conduct Mann-Whitney U test, no cup coffee with the 1 cup coffee. Okay, so if p value less than 0.05, it means there is a significant difference. If it is greater than, there is no significant difference. So we can say 1 cup coffee does not increase significantly heart rate score. Okay, now we will check no cup coffee with the 2 cup coffee. Then we will check the p value. If p value less than 0.05, then we can say 2 cup coffee increases the heart rate score. And the third condition, we compare no cup coffee with the 4 cup coffee. If p value is less than 0.05, then we will say there is a significant difference between the group. Okay, so now this is all about the Kruskal Wallis test. Now next is Friedman ANOVA, which is equivalent to the repeated measures ANOVA. Okay, so in this test, Friedman ANOVA, so it is used for testing differences between conditions. There are more than 2 conditions. More than 2 condition means one condition, one observation, second observations means one condition, second condition, third condition, repeatedly we are taking the observations. So here we will use the Friedman ANOVA, and so I will explain this Friedman ANOVA through this particular example, that is the marketing campaign. So to test the marketing campaign, the researcher took 15 retail outlets who considered being in need of increasing sales and putting them on this campaign for 2 months. Okay, So means ki after 1 month, this particular researcher measuring the output of the 15 retail outlets, and after 2 months, so he wanted to know whether the sales increasing or not. Okay, so now I am taking the case study, that is the one sample test, non-parametric test. So in one sample, will Coxcon rank sign test? So this is my data. So first day customer came 50, 55, 54. And he said ki mini median value 53. Okay. So analyze, I am performing non-parametric test for one sample. This is my test one sample test. The value of the test is 0.935. It means there is no significant difference. If p value greater than 0.05, it means there is a significant difference. Now main Whitney U test. So this is the there are two group. One group for ecstasy tablet, 10 people, and score Sunday score is this, and alcohol score that is the Sunday and Wednesday. Okay, so we can perform two times main Whitney, one for Sunday data and one test for Wednesday. So first of all, I want to know whether the mean rank of this particular group significantly different from alcohol or not. Okay, how will I perform? I will go to analyze, non-parametric test, PKC dialogues, and two independent sample. This is my route to perform the independent sample t-test. Okay, so here two independent sample. I will perform types of drug into the grouping variable, and I will put my coding, that is 1 and 2. Okay, and one by one I will perform, and I can perform I can take both the variables simultaneously. So here test the variable this exact, and then nothing to do, and then option descriptive statistics, if we need we can pick it, and then okay, so here we can see by default it is giving main Whitney U test, and then okay, so this is my result. So mean rank, so here mean rank of 10 people, it means 11 point. The sum of rank, what is the sum of rank? 119. How this particular score came? So I discussed through this score 119. Okay, we add all the score, and this is 119, and for alcohol group people the score is 90.5. when we take the average divided by the this particular value by 10, then mean rank is 11.95, and the mean rank of alcohol group, that is 9.05. I already told you many times, when we compare two means, always we will get the different value, but this particular different value, whether this is significant or not, who will tell us? P value. So this is our p value, p value. So p test statistics p value. So here we can see the value of the main Whitney that is 35, Z value minus 1.05. We need only this value, okay, asymptotically significant, that is 0.269. It means this difference is not significant. It is different, but not significant. So I will perform it again because my data moves and this dialogue to independent sample t-test and this. Okay, so here this difference is, there is a difference, but it is not significant because p-value greater than 0.05. It means it is 26.9%. Okay, now second case for day Wednesday, again there is a difference, and we can see there is a significant difference, but who will tell us whether this particular difference significant or not? P-value, and here p-value is 0.00, which is less than 0.05. so we can see the significant difference on Wednesday data, not Sunday data. Now I am taking another case study of Wilcoxon rank sign. So Wilcoxon sign rank test for two dependent samples. So here Wilcoxon, where is Wilcoxon? One sample, repeated Wilcoxon. This is my data, okay, and this is my data, that is Sunday data, depression level of 10% on Sunday, and depression score of Wednesday. So I want to check whether this difference significant or not. So I will perform a pair equivalent of pair t-test, that is Wilcoxon rank sign test, analyze, and non-parametric test, and then two related sample, okay, two related sample, and then I will transfer both the variables, and then we can see here by default Wilcoxon rank sign test, and then exact, nothing to do, okay, and then this achha kal kitne baje
Dr. Pandya, any problem?
analyze a non-parametric test, legacy dialogue, and two related sample. So two related sample, then I transferred both the variable, here variable 1 and variable 2, and here we can see by default Wilcoxon, and then okay, and after okay we will get the result. So here we can see the value, that is p value 0.012. it means it is less than 0.05. it means if we give the continuously medicine to our patient, then effect will happen. Okay, now next test, that is after Wilcoxon, I will perform a Kruskal-Welisch test. I am opening the file of Kruskal-Welisch test. Okay, this is file of Kruskal-Welisch test, and then this is my data. So here we can see I have explained through my PPT this example. When we are not giving coffee per day of my 10 participants, the heart rate score 62, 81, 94, this is heart rate score of 10 people. When we are giving one cup coffee of 10 respondents, so heart rate will go out of this. When we are giving 10 cup coffee per day of 10 respondents or participants, the heart rate of this. And when we give the coffee of our participants, then 4 cup coffee per day, the heart rate score of this. So we want to compare several ranks, mean ranks. We will not compare mean value. We will compare mean ranks, rank of this, rank of this group, rank of this group, and rank of this group. Okay, so it is equivalent to analysis of variance. Then how to perform it? Analyze, and then non-parametric test, and non-parametric test, k independent samples. Okay, so k independent sample, we will transfer coffee consumption into this group, and what is the value, minimum value 1, and what is the maximum value 4. So here we will write minimum value 1, maximum value 4, because 4 level here. Then continue. We will transfer this variable into test variable list, and then by default we can see here Kruskal Wallis test, and then okay. So this is when there is no coffee, the mean rank of 16.35, 1 cup coffee 19.,  2 cup coffee is 14., and when people are taking 4 cup coffee, heart rate score, mean score is 31. It is very significantly different. And here we can see the p value, which is 0.006, less than 0.05. But here we cannot say which particular group is impacting to increase the heart rate score. Although we can see this particular 4 cup coffee impacting more. But here we will perform 3 times Mann Whitney U test, which particular group is impacting more. So analyze, this is the post of analysis, because there is no post of analysis facility, post of analysis facility, non-parametric test. So we will perform 3 times Mann Whitney U test. Okay, so this is the route to perform the Mann Whitney U test. To independent sample coffee consumption, first we perform one no cup coffee with 1 cup coffee, okay, 1 to 2, then continue, and then okay, we will check the result. What is the p value? 0.05. it means there is no problem if you are taking 1 cup coffee per day. Now we perform one cup coffee with 1 cup coffee with no cup coffee with 2 cup coffee, third group, then continue. So what is the value? That is 0.850. there is no problem when you take 2 cup coffee. It is a hypothetical case study. And then analyze, we compare 4 cup coffee. So here we can see 1 2 independent sample. This is 4. This 4, so that is continue and continue. Okay, then what is the value? 0.03. it means we should not take 4 or 5 cup coffee per day. Our heart rate score may increase. Now I am taking another case study of, that is Wilcoxon rank sign test. Okay, so not Wilcoxon, Friedman Innova.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, we take these tests, Mann Whitney tests, repeatedly for pairwise comparison in case of non-parametric.
No.
Because it means it will not be giving post hoc test, right, sir?
Yes.
So Mann Whitney lekar pairwise humko dekhna padega sir post hoc.
Yes. You are right.
So what, sir? What we are doing two way ANOVA, sir, in case of non-parametric test?
Okay. Two way ANOVA, factorial ANOVA, is tarah ki. तो वो बहुत सारे टेस्ट हैं ऐसे, क्योंकि हम वी कैन नॉट कवर ऑल दी टॉपिक्स. सो आई कैन शो यू दी स्लाइड्स, जस्ट वेट.
Can you see this particular slide?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. I am just explaining it. So, okay, so you can see this particular this page from the Andy Field book. So here we have large number of tables, test, main Whitney, dependent Wilcoxon, one-way ANOVA, one-way repeated measures ANOVA, Friedman ANOVA, Pearson, factorial ANOVA, and factorial mixed ANOVA, factorial repeated measures ANOVA, multiple regression ANOVA, and COVA. So means we have not covered many statistical tools and technique. If you want go in detail, then you go through this particular book. Okay, so here we are just aware about the few tests.
Sir, kaun se book bola aapne, sir?
Andy Field, madam. Andy Field hai, discovery of statistics. usme dekhiye madam, aapka Andy Field, you can means you can perform ANOVA, ANCOVA, factorial ANOVA, factorial means we have large number of statistical tools and techniques.
Okay,
so
sir.
If you want to go in detail. So now next, this is the score of 10 people. So marketing campaign. The baseline score of 15 outlet, this baseline, after 1 month score of this, after 2 month score of this. Okay, so it is when we measure same respondent more than two times, it is known as repeated measures ANOVA test. But data not normally distributed, that is why we use Friedman ANOVA, then analyze, and then non-parametric test, and then K related sample, because we have more than two related sample. So here we can see K related samples, and simultaneously we will take only values. And we here we can see Friedman and exact, and then continue statistics, then continue and okay. So here we can see the sales after 1 month. So baseline, that is two, mean rank 2 million, 1.87, and so we want to check whether this difference significant or not. So who will tell us this particular asymptotically? Tell us there is no significant difference because p value that is greater than 0.05. okay, so this is all about the Friedman ANOVA. One test I will, that is chi-square test. Okay, this is the chi-square test. Again, this case study from the Discovering of Statistics Andy Field book. So you can see this case study, 200 cats. Okay, so 150, we are giving incentive to the cats, and there are two options. We are giving, we have taken 150 cats, and we are giving food as a reward, some cats, and we are giving affection as a reward to some cats. Okay, so we have divided, we are giving a reward, two types of reward. For one group, we are giving food as a reward, another group, we are giving affection as a reward. And then after giving the food, and we, the trainer want to whether the these cats will dance or not. So there are two options. So after giving the food as a reward, there are two options: cats may dance or cat may not dance. Okay, so same as when we are giving the affection, so cats may dance or cats may not dance. So basically it is a categorical data. One, that is food versus affection, and dance, yes versus no.
So both the variables are categorical variable. So we will estimate this data through chi-square test only. So analyze, descriptive statistics, and cross steps. Okay. We will transfer row here and column here, and then exact, nothing to do, statistics, chi-square test, continue, and then cells. So expected frequencies, we need percentage, continue, and format, nothing to do, and then finally, okay. So this is my result output. When we are giving the food as a reward, so how many cats, we are giving food for 30 cats out of 150. So 66% cats are dancing and 33% not dancing. Affection as a reward, 120 cats we have given affection as a reward, and we can see 37.5% cat dance and 62.5% did not dance. So we want to check which particular reward works for animals, food or affection. So here we can see food is impacting more because 67% and here 37.5. Whether this difference significantly different or not, who will tell us? P-value, and here chi-square p-value, that is 0.004. It means affection, food as a reward works for 10 the cats. So this p-value, that is less than 0.05. So aaj ke liye today, aaj ke liye hum itna hi rakhenge, and tomorrow we will start, we will take the multiple regression discriminant in logistics. Yes.
Sir, agar if food as a reward, affection as a reward ke saath no reward, teen hota.
Aise bhi ho sakta hai. मैडम वो भी आप ले सकते हैं, ये तो मैंने समझाने के लिए कहा, थ्री ऑप्शंस भी हो सकते हैं कैटेगरी नो रिवार्ड, फूड एज ए रिवार्ड,
ओनर्स विल बी ऑन दैट पर्सन,
वो भी हम कर सकते हैं.
एंट्री कैसे करेंगे सर उसमें, एसपीएसएस में तीन तीन वाला रहेगा, तो
तीन वाले में जैसे हमने ये वाला एंट्री किया है, इसमें फूड एज ए रिवार्ड एक हो गया, ठीक है, तो ये वन हो गया, टू हो गया, और उसमें तीसरा जो कैटेगरी है वो हम यहाँ पे लेंगे थ्री, और उसका रिजल्ट यहाँ पे लिखेंगे, हम चार कैटेगरी होगी, फिर एक और ग्रुप बना देंगे, इस तरीके से एंट्री करेंगे.
ओके सर, थैंक यू
थैंक यू थैंक यू
सर. एक बार अगर आज या कल में हो पाता तो काइंडली आउटलायर्स एक बार जल्दी से बता देते, कभी भी आउटलायर्स कैसे हटाते हैं उसमें नॉर्मेलिटी टेस्ट करके.
कल आप हमें याद दिला दीजिए, कल हटा देंगे, है ना.
ओके
सर. सर
एक्सक्यूज मी सर.
हां बोलिए
सर. जब हम लिकर्ट स्केल यूज करते हैं तब हमारा डेटा ऑर्डिनल डेटा बन जाता है ना.
हाँ.
तो फिर सर वो जब डेटा ऑर्डिनल होता है तो इज इट ट्रू कि वो नॉर्मल नहीं होता मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स ऑर्डिनल डेटा.
देखिए ऐसा है, थ्योरेटिकली जो लिकर्ट स्केल है वो हमारा ऑर्डिनल डेटा है, लेकिन हम लोग ज्यादातर 90% उसको ट्रीट कर लेते हैं इंटरवल स्केल की तरह, ठीक है, तो उसकी हम नॉर्मलिटी भी चेक कर लेते हैं. तो मैं तो सबको यही सजेस्ट करता हूँ, जब लिकर्ट स्केल पर अगर आप क्वेश्चन बना रहे हैं तो उसको 5 पॉइंट ना बना के, उसको 5 पॉइंट ना बना के 9 पॉइंट या 11 पॉइंट पर बनाएंगे, तब वो डेटा हमारा जो है इंटरवल की तरह होगा, तब वो हमारा ओरिजिनल डेटा नहीं रहेगा, ठीक है ना. लेकिन अगर हम 5 पॉइंट, लेकिन हमारे यहाँ पे ज्यादातर हम केस देख रहे हैं कि सभी लोग 5 पॉइंट लिकर्ट स्केल लेके उसको इंटरवल डेटा की तरह ट्रीट करते हैं, और उसकी नॉर्मलिटी भी होमोजेनिटी भी वो सब फाइंड करते हैं. बट थ्योरेटिकली हमें जो है, थ्योरेटिकली वी शुड टेक, सो व्हेन वी कैन यू हेलो
ओके
सुन पा रहे हैं आप मुझे
हेलो
Okay. So basically, when we take a 5-point Likert scale, it is truly ordinal data. Okay, but most of the cases we can see here, we treated this data as a interval data, but theoretically it is not interval data. It is Likert scale. It is ordinal data. So what should we do? We should increase the width of this data. Instead of 5 point, we should prepare our question 9-point scale or 11-point scale. Then it becomes the interval data, and then find the normality and homogeneity of this data.
So can I add, please?
Okay, sir.
Can I add, please?
Yes.
See, Shruti ji and everybody, sir is right in his saying that when you take Likert scale in its original form, so even if you read the person who has developed this scale, Rensis Likert, he even said that this is a data which is cannot be it's only a ranking data, it cannot be made to a normal scale. So if you want to make a Likert scale, everybody, yes, I agree with this sir also that everybody use only one scale. There are, I think, 110 scales which can be used, but most of the people use Likert scale. This Likert scale in its basic essence is only about measuring agreement continuum. And the moment you measure the agreement continuum, my agreement continuum difference cannot be as same as your agreement continuum, right? So in its basic essence, it's a rank data, it's a ordinal data. If you want to convert it to a let's say interval data, so yes, either you extend it and don't put the median point of neutral, or extend it to the 11 point, or else you can do that, you can assign weights, means 1 means let's say 10, 2 means let's say 20, to assign the weights, then only you can convert this ordinal scale into a interval scale. Am I right, sir?
Yes, you're right.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Sir, I have one question, if you don't mind.
I think questions can be taken
if after
either by mail.
To practice, once you people practice all these things and question can be taken, it's already 9 o'clock and
Let me take your simple question. Homogeneity. In case of homogeneity, how to identify the homogeneity? The sample is homogeneity. If we apply the t-test or the, if we apply the one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA, whatever. So how to identify the homogeneity and what are the values? On that basis, you can be say this is the